Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, our seventh video on index form, and we're talking about unit fraction powers. Now just a little warning, you must have watched all the previous videos on index form to do this one because we're combining a lot of rules, and you must also have watched the square and the square root videos so you're fully aware of those. Okay, previously on Hegarty Maths, I've asked you on the power of the power video to be able to work this out, and you did. You would have said that 2 to the half all squared is 2 to the half times 2, which is simply 2 to the 1, which is 2. And you would have said that 7 to the third all cubed is equal to 7 to the third times 3, which is 7 to the 1, and the answer would be 7. We did that in the power of the power video right at the end, okay? Now, I haven't told you what 2 to the half means or 7 to the third even means, but you know, assuming they exist, that you can multiply the powers and you'll get 2. Now let's think about what they must mean now just from this. If we know this is true from our power of the power videos, let's think what it means. Now 2 to the half is something. Let's say we don't know what it is, but when you square it you get 2. So let's think about that. Something, when you square it you get 2. What must the thing be? Well, it must be the square root of 2, mustn't it? It must be the square root of 2, because the only thing that multiplies by itself to get 2 is the square root of 2. So therefore, that's telling us that 2 to the half multiplied by 2 to the half, which is 2 to the half all squared, the 2 to the half here must mean the square root of 2. So here's a little learning for us. 2 to the half must mean the square root of 2. It just has to. And couldn't 2 to the half be negative root 2? Because with square roots you always get a positive and negative answer. Well, it could, but we would call negative 2 to the half negative root 2. So whenever you just see 2 to the half, assume it's the positive square root of 2. Let's just see if we can generate the same thing from 7 to the power of a third. Now, 7 to the third cubed means something multiplied by itself 3 times gives me the answer 7. Okay, now that's something that is multiplying by itself, is out of interest, 7 to the power of a third. Now, what must 7 to the power of a third be? If you were saying what must go in the box, well, it must be the cube root of 7. It's literally got to be the cube root of 7, because the only number that cubes to give 7 is the cube root of 7. So here's another bit of learning. We've learnt, therefore, that 7 to the third must be equal to the cube root of 7. And therefore, these things here are called unit fractions. The reason they're called unit fractions is because there's a 1 on the top. Unit fractions. Always of the form 1 over a number. Okay, so 1 over 8 or something like that. So 2 to the power of a half is the square root of 2. 7 to the power of a third is the cube root of 7. What do you think something like 8 to the power of a quarter is? It's going to be the fourth root of 8. So we have worked out, just by using something we previously know, what 2 to the power of a half or a third or a quarter or any unit fraction must actually mean. So let's actually write this down properly. Powers of unit fractions. So 2 to the half means the square root of 2 we have just found. 3 to the half means the square root of 3. 4 to the half is the square root of 4, which out of interest is an answer that we should know is 2, and 5 to the half is the square root of 5. Now, what does 2 to the third mean? It means the cube root of 2. What does 8 to the third mean? The cube root of 8, which we should actually know the cube root of 8 is actually 2. What does 4 to the third mean? It means the cube root of 4. And what does 5 to the third mean? It means the third root of 5. Now, what about going on to a quarter, etc.? 2 to the quarter must mean the fourth root of 2. 8 to the quarter must mean the fourth root of 8. 4 to the quarter must mean the fourth root of 4. And 5 to the quarter must mean the fourth root of 5. And there we go. They are many of the unit fractions we'll be expected to know. So in general, our base number to the power of a unit fraction, 1 over n, what does that mean? It means the nth root of our base number. Okay, so let's do another one. Let's say something like 27 to the third. That means the third root of 27, and we know what the third root or the cube root of 27 is. What number multiplied by itself 3 times gets 27? It's 3. So that's what powers of unit fractions are all about, and that's what we have to remember. I think we're ready to try some questions. Let's have a go. Evaluate, work out the following. 4 to the half means the square root of 4, which is 2. 100 to the half means the square root of 100, which is 10. 8 to the power of a third means the cube root of 8, which we should know is 2. And 32 to the power of a fifth means the fifth root of 32. Now, if you're struggling with that, what number multiplied by itself 5 times gives you 32? Well, hopefully you can see it's going to be 2. Now, while we're at it, let's revise some negative powers as well. If we know that 4 to the half is 2, what's 4 to the negative half? Well, it must be 1 over the square root of 4, i.e. 1 over 2, isn't it? It must be 1 over the answer to what we got for this one, because remember, negative power means just 1 over the same thing but to positive power. What would 100 to the negative a half be? Well, it would mean 1 over 100 to the half, which is the square root of 100, and the square root of 100 is 1 over, that would be 1 over 10, wouldn't it? And let's keep going. 8 to the negative third, that must mean 1 over the cube root of 8, and the cube root of 8 is 2, so it's 1 over 2. And the last one, 32 to the negative fifth will be 1 over the fifth root of 32, and the fifth root of 32 is 2, so it's a half. So just spot the pattern. 4 to the half is 2, 4 to the negative half, 1 over 2. 100 to the half is 10, 100 to the negative half, 1 over 10. 8 to the third is 2, 8 to the negative third is 1 over 2. 32 to the fifth is 2, 32 to the negative fifth is 1 over 2. And there's a bit of practice of our negative powers as well. Right, pause the video and try and write the following with a square root sign or a cube root sign. 3 to the half just means root 3. There's not a whole number answer to that, so leave it like that. 7 to the half means root 7. 7 to the third means cube root 7. 11 to the quarter means 4 through 11. And 100 to the fifth means fifth through 100. We always leave our answers like that when the square root, cube root, fourth root, fifth root, etc. is not a whole number. Right, let's try another one. Write the following in index form now. Go from the surd or the square root form to index form. Square root of 17, the way of writing that in index form is 17 to the power of, that's right, a half. Now sometimes I put a 2 there for square root. Most of the time mathematicians are lazy and they leave it out. When they leave it out, they mean that it's the square root, okay? So this here again would be 11 to the half. But the cube root of 11 is 11 to the third, that's right. And the fourth root of 5 is 5 to the quarter, that's right, okay? Right, why don't you try these ones now? Write them in surd form. Well, 3 to the negative half means 1 over 3 to the half. And we know 3 to the half is root 3, so it's 1 over root 3. 7 to the negative half means 1 over 7 to the positive half, which is therefore 1 over square root 7. And the last one, 11 to the negative third means 1 over the cube root of 11. Simple as that, and we're done. So let's try another one. Pause the video and have a go if you want to. So this is linking with our previous learning. We're trying to write this in index or power form. So 1 over the square root of 5. What's square root of 5? It's 5 to the half, that's right. So this is 1 over 5 to the half. And 1 over 5 to the half in a single power form is 5 to the negative half, that's right. Because 5 to the negative half means 1 over 5 to the half means 1 over root 5. So this was just going backwards. And there you go, you've written it in index form. Let's try another question. Write this as a single power of 2. So we're using our law of multiplication of powers here. So let's give that a go. That's a 2, really 2 to the power of 1, isn't it? So we've got 2 to the power of 1 multiplied by, what's the square root of 2 written in power form? 2 to the half, that's right. And when you're multiplying powers and the base number's the same, you can add the powers, so this will be 2 to the 1 and a half. Or writing 1 and a half as an improper fraction, 2 to the 3 over 2. Let's do the same in this case with 5 here. We've got 5 squared, that is in power form, but we've got the cube root of 5. We need to write that in power form. What's that in power form? That's 5 to the third. So when you're multiplying, you can add the powers. That's going to be 5 to the 2 and a third, which if you put it in improper fraction, that would be 5 to the 7 thirds, and we're done. And last example, let's practice our division. Let's write these as single powers of 5. So that's 5 squared divided by 5 to the, that's right, half. And when you're dividing, you can subtract the powers. So this is going to be 5 to the 2 subtract a half, which is 1 and a half. And you could write that as an improper fraction, 5 to the 3 over 2. And the last one here, really we've got 5 to the 1, and we're dividing it by, that's over sign, dividing it by 5 to the third, that's right. And when you're dividing, you can subtract the powers, so that's going to be 5 to the 1 subtract the third, which is 5 to the 2 thirds. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.